Hello, this is Rhett. Don't know how I Hello, this is RedMcNed, and welcome back to the saga. And before anyone says anything, I'm gonna take care of something I saw in the last video. Not sure how I missed that little beauty. So I'm gonna jeez. A little too rock and roll. I'm gonna go ahead and fix that. There's probably other things like that around, but I'm not gonna worry about that just now. I'm still pretty happy that all the houses are up, and don't have to worry about building those anymore, which means I can go on to other things. Now, as you can see, business as usual. I need to keep collecting sugarcane and keep breeding cows because we need those enchants. So that's what I'm gonna do right now. Wait, I gotta drop off stuff. Running into bed as usual. Okay. All right. So, we're gonna need to light this up. We can't keep living on the edge like this. You can't let me live on the edge like this. So you guys just say, "Ah, whatever. He'll go play around." I need to light this up. All right, so task at hand. Let's get some sugarcane. Misplaced my crafting table. Right. Eat some bread. Now gotta hunt down all of the. That's another thing. Gotta. All right, one thing at a time. We'll eventually get these cows placed as they need to be. Right now, this is looking like a pretty free range. They've taken over the area. And I'm the farmer. I make the rules. I should be able to decide where they go. Yeah. Oh, good. Good work. Good work, cow. Staying vigilant. And you, sheep. Sheep and cow. Good job. Guarding the most important part of this place. All right, come over here. Oh wait, I don't have the sound on. There we go. I knew something was missing. Something crucial. Know, I think I might keep the rest just to feed myself. So. I need to get rid of these trees. Ah, I'll wait. So something I want to do though before I move on is I want to make some mushroom stew out of those. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna, harvest some mushrooms. Hopefully. Yeah, I'm getting some. I'm getting mushrooms out of this. Oh, and these have been multiplying without my my knowledge. So if mushrooms are in the dark and plant on the ground, they will start to spread around, which is quite nice. So I will admit this was probably the sloppiest job growing a mushroom, just because I decided to do it right in the middle of a tree. The middle of several trees. But, just as long as you have bone meal, just hit a mushroom with it that's on the ground and there's nothing around it, and should grow the large version of it. So to make mushroom stew, I need to make bowls. Don't really know how many I can hold. I can make four of them. Unfortunately, they do not stack though. So they do fill up the inventory. But they are more filling than bread. So we can keep them around. And the bowls do stack afterwards. So see, I'm gonna have some right now. I'm gonna drop off the rest of these in an appropriate chest. All right, so I need to get this out. We need to. I've decided that what's going to happen is I'm going to take these tools. I don't think I need these anymore now that I have diamond, actually. So, take the diamonds pick, and I need to go mining. I'm going to go mining and get some materials. So I'll get this all ready and head on down there. So we're gonna go mining, and I'm gonna set up basically the mine shaft. I don't think that's actually. I'll bring another diamond. I'm gonna make a shovel out of this one. All right, so for now, this is a pretty good loadout. I'm gonna go ahead and take the crafting table too, because when I branch mine, I actually take this with me. So let's head down there. Guess I don't always have to use the ladder. Extreme sports every day. So, I'm going to. When I get down there, I'm going to make a chest. And we already have one tunnel sort of here. But I don't have to bring all of my resources with me all the time. So let's put this here. I believe this will be the main direction. This way, back and forth. So, I mentioned in the last video, and I'll put the description in. I'll put a description. I'll put a link in the description. In the I'll put the link in the description. I'll do that. I'll put a link in the description of the video. That kind of sums up how I branch mine. And I always pick a long ways two directions. Just thinking about that last statement. Long ways two directions. That's everything in life, and in just a couple words. So I usually actually go ahead and make this a 3x3 tunnel for the main one. And that shoots off in both directions. And from this, I have branches that go out on either side. So what I will do is I'll just go a little bit in, but I'm probably going to stop really soon. And diamond tools are so much faster. Oh my god, they're so fast. And I'm like, yeah. So we kind of explored that way already. So I'm going to go this way now. And if this ends up being like a central room that's big, then we'll start it here. I'm going to mark it here. And what I'm going to do is make a 2x2 tunnel. And every six spots, I'll put a torch. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Each of these torches is going to be a cross section where more branch mines happen. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And that basically means there's going to be a tunnel here. And a tunnel here, tunnel here, and here. Now, the reason why I spread them out so far is also explained in that lovely video in the description. But basically, what it says is if you find veins of ores and stuff, if you have a tunnel just right next to it, you'll probably hit the sp you would see the same ones that you already dug up, so you'd be being a little bit redundant. And some coal veins can actually reach pretty far, so the further your tunnels are apart, actually it's better, because you won't risk seeing the same areas multiple times, or the same veins of minerals. And you don't actually have to be, especially in solo survival, you don't have to be thorough. Like, you don't have to take every resource out of every chunk. You don't have to get everything. And I know that might seem counterintuitive, but if you're spending a bunch of time digging tunnels that already go through minerals you've already mined, you're actually wasting a lot of time. Potentially. So I kind of do, that's why I do the big spacing. So let's go ahead and pick one. Let's pick this one. What I like to do is I like to have a pick, a shovel, a sword, just in case stuff goes down, food, a block for stacking with, and a crafting table. So I'm gonna actually go back and get this. I also only like to have a maximum of really three stacks of torches. I don't think I'll actually even need more than two. I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of some of these because they're a little bit redundant. So if I have my food there, I have this. If I had a second type of pick, I would actually put it here. So this would be my normal workforce pick. This would be my specialty pick, like if it's Silk Touch or Fortune. And my stackable block, my crafting table, my food. It's kind of overflowing into this area, but oh well. And any additional torches. But this is enough to get started. This is a pretty darn good setup, actually. Plus, we already have a couple diamond tools, so that's going to help a lot. And I got armor and a bucket of water. I said that, I think maybe. But I have that for reasons I've defined. For reasons I've defined. Reasons I've defined. So, as you see, it does get darker, darker, darker. This is the darkest right here. So I don't just put a torch on the darkest, though. In the beginning, I believe mobs won't spawn in areas that are light level 7 away from a torch. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And that means I have to put another torch equal distance that way. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it turns out actually this is not a bad spot to put a torch. But I like to go ahead and give it a little extra because we're gonna have a bunch of torches. And I still put torch on the left. That's just the direction I decide to go with. So if the torches are on the left, I'm heading away. If they're on the right, then I'm heading back to base. And really, that's how I usually do my mines like this too. So this is what it really looks like. And when I'm done with the branch, I'll usually I'll show you how I'd finish. But anyways, I sort of continue. And what I could do is I could pick these up, but I'd rather go all the way first. Go really far. If it's in front of me, I can't help it. I'll go ahead and mine it. Actually, you know what? For the sake of this, I will take this because it's going to help explain a few things. Like, why do I have an extra spot that I'm using the crafting table? Hey, you know what? I am going to take that just because I'm going to totally forget that that's there. But this would be a great time to have a silk touch. I'm going to go ahead and throw a torch down in here because it looks dark enough to possibly have bad things come in. So cool, that means we have our first emerald. Also, this kind of helps illustrate that why I have the mines the six apart. If they were only one apart, this wouldn't be anything new coming through here. Even two apart or three apart, and even four apart if I was along here. And that just means I find more things. Also, what I do to ease my troubles is go ahead and make the floor flat because I will be returning along this way. So anyways, I'm gonna dig like this for a little while. All right, so we found some more diamond. That's pretty darn awesome. So, diamond usually doesn't happen alone, so it helps to kind of look around it. It helps really well to look around it, actually. This looks like about six pieces of diamond right here. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm not going to mine this. I'm just going to remember that it's here. In fact, I'll put a torch on the ground because I usually don't do that. And if I see that from over there, I'll know what this means because I barely ever do this whenever I go branch mining. So that is very nice. I don't think I need to get more diamond yet, though. Oh, I do need two of them for a enchantment table. So that should be good. As you will see or have seen, coal happens a lot. So I'm not really in and wood's pretty easy to come by too, so I don't really skimp on the torches. A lot of people are just running along really fast and don't put torches down, but I really like to go for a safe, safety safe. Ah, splendid. So, like I said before, I'm not going to be mining these. This is actually very nice. It's the other one's just right there, so this one gets one as well. See how great this works? And yes, I am at level 11 right now. I never said that, but I am. So you will get sections where it seems like nothing's happening. And that's fine. That happens. Just know that it's you'll probably find stuff. The law of averages. See. Oh my. Okay. So time to be careful. This is why I like having the blocks on me. If you stand close enough, you'll probably catch whatever you're mining. See, I'm gonna go ahead and leave this here. Whoops. This emeralds. Ooh. So I don't know if a cave is actually, if a branch mine is going to hit this area. So maybe I will kind of look around in here. So I'm gonna do the quick bucket of water. Put down, pick up really fast to make a little bridge. It looks like we have a little area that we can kind of look at. And as long as this is the cool thing about branch mining, in my opinion, is it can lead to lovely underground caves. And I don't know when the last time it was that I've had to find a stronghold or a mine shaft that I didn't just find branch mining this way. Like usually you find something. That's kind of over there. I'll leave that. I'll make this a wide corner. This is gonna help me get back. So this looks like trouble. I'm just gonna get rid of trouble. Nothing says you can't just get rid of whatever's causing you any panic. So let's see. We're at 13. This is still a level that's pretty. You can still find diamonds on walls and stuff. Look at that, a bunch of lovely minerals. So, go ahead and mine those. I don't mine. See, I actually do hear really quietly running water. But I don't think I'm going to investigate right now. I do hear a zombie also. I did not light up everything in here. So it's possible I could have a friend. Gosh, I'm gonna go check it out. Oh, there's so many. Okay. Oh, here, baby zombies. Yep, there is a cave that goes up further. And, well, let's see. Alright, this is an interesting dilemma. Because I know for a fact that there's another cave nearby, because I can hear the mobs. And I would actually rather find that cave and light it up, because you never know if there's like a dungeon or anything cool in one, or where they'll go. And if I want to do like a mob spawner or anything at some point in time, it's good to kind of make sure that if it's going to be near home, that the caves are all lit up, because that's less spaces for any mobs to spawn. I'm going to mine these resources really fast. Alright, so this is where I'm at. I definitely hear stuff around here. Oh, I forgot to get these. But the thing is, they go away. When I come over here, I actually hear water. But I don't hear those guys anymore. Oh, okay. So, once again, these don't always dead end, so sometimes it's worth going through them. Yep, there's the water. May or may not be bad guys here now, but I better light it up really fast before any show up. So there's actually a very big area. This is level 20, so it's a bit higher than diamond level. So I probably won't find diamonds in here, but it is a cave. Probably find resources. I believe that's one of the zombies that was making noises. So I'll just have to remember it's there. That goes into another area. I'm out of torches. They're almost better than a sword. I believe I may have lost track. Okay, I believe there's an area up there where they could come from. So I'm going to try to make quick work of this guy. Not making quick work. There's the baby. It's coming. Oh, it's a villager baby. Unfortunately, I don't want to deal with you. Come on, die. Okay. Oh, interesting. So we have a room. Let's light this up really fast. I'd rather get the torches down first than risk having lots of areas for new things to spawn. Level 22. It's going down. I'm gonna go ahead and stairway up to this area just to see what's up here. I do hear noises. I don't see any. Okay, there's. I just saw the back leg of a zombie. Wonderful. And I'm really glad I'm using my scheme For okay. Zombie, there it is. So wondering where it was going. I'm using my torch scheme. Oops, screenshot it accidentally. Right, looks like this is the best bet because it's going back down. I think the light reaches those, so we're good there. We're back to diamond levels. All right. Well, there's some stuff. Okay. So you can get rid of water by placing a block or by placing a torch. That's going to help go down there. I'm going to rediscover the rest of this. Looks like there's another area in there. There is, in fact, another area. I'm going to replenish the torches. Okay. So we are finding some caves. Okay. I thought it was just going to be a straight shot, but standard branch mining. But when they run into caves, you can't like not go in them. Like who does that? It's a boring person, probably. I don't know. Maybe a smart person because they're playing it safe. This is still going down. Nothing too crazy. I might have more mine than I can deal with right now. Like as far as resources I can bring back. This looks like this is a collapsed cave. I'm not gonna worry about that. I'm just gonna get the resources and get out of here. I've gotten quite a few. Definitely have what is needed. Almost what's needed. I need to actually get some obsidian. Glad I remembered that. For the enchantment table. Hey, you know what? This is so far out of the way that I'm gonna go ahead and mine this. Also, this pick isn't gonna last forever, so even if I get a good enchantment on it, I'd rather just start with a fresh pick. Also, you could say that I'm kind of wasting my time getting all of these pieces of coal, but need I remind you that I have not lit up anything. There's very little that I've lit up, lighted up. So this stuff is going to be very useful for me actually not having things coming around. Especially if you're starting to build stuff, you don't want any creepers coming around. Like maybe you do, maybe that's your thing. I'm not going to step on that. But for me, that's not what I want. So I'm going to work my way back now, which means I'm going to be harvesting all the minerals I passed. Now this starts to get kind of confusing in here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put up a bar here that says I've already gone this way. So that's kind of how I keep track and don't get caught up in like dead ends and stuff, and that can help me find my way out too. If I wasn't doing the torch thing, then I would at least be doing that. And actually, the inventory is getting full, which means I get to demonstrate why I have the crafting table. And I think you already know Minerals can be turned into blocks, and those will find homes in your inventory a lot easier. And that's really a useful thing. The only thing that would be more useful is if I had an ender chest, so I can bring up, it's like bringing a backpack with you, essentially. So there you have it. That's all of my, those are all of my ways that I carry things. So that's, that bar means I'm done. Also, if I come from another direction and I see one of those, it means that I'm coming to an area that I've already dealt with. Oh, I just hit level 30. So anything else is bonus. Now if I had Silk Touch, then I could take things that would give me levels and not mind them right now. I'm not going to worry about the smaller things. Like, I could make a block of this, but that won't save any space. And I don't have it. I'll probably have to put it back anyways. Anyways, that gives us extra room. Yeah. It's sort of nuanced, but you start to realize where and you can put torches to make sure that no bad things spawn. Like, there's a certain distancing and certain darkness of squares you start to notice. Commemorate this with a torch. Even if I don't think I'm going back, I still don't want to have spots where I'm slowly removing spots where bad things can spawn until eventually there'll be no spots. What I just remembered is, of all the excavating and mine, like, discovery from, like, the cave diving episode, I didn't actually collect very much of those resources. So they're all kind of sitting there out in the open. So maybe I need to go back there sometime. Not today, but sometime. It's always fun when a vein just, like, leads to more stuff. It's like, you didn't have to do that, but I'm really happy you did. One of the things you can do if you don't want stuff to spawn up high is just bring the floor down. It's all bright down here. There, now there's no cliffs. So on the way back, I get to do this part. This is the return journey. I'm going to have this. Put this in the pile. And what I do on the way back is I count two. And this is where I kind of poke in to see if I see any more stuff. I think there's a cave Yeah, there's a cave. Alright, well, this doesn't usually happen. I'm going to actually oh, this is a really scary looking place, actually. I'm going to save this for another time. I don't usually poke into caves, but I guess it can happen. I'm going to do this. Okay. But what I do is I go two from either side, and I poke in case I find something like that. Like, if I do, cool. And I usually just pick one side because if I do two sides, these branch mines, there's going to be parallel paths like this. And like if I always go on the side of the torches, then it's easy for me to count away from them. Look, I found some more. I won't end up being redundant. Like if the next parallel over is digging toward this, then I'm just covering the same area again. So it's all quite methodical. Now, if it's coal, eh, I'm not gonna worry about it. Plus, the other mine will probably hit it. What I could do is I could also dig straight up, but I'd rather not have stuff fall on me. It's just a preference I have, not having stuff fall on me. But as you see, you can find some stuff this way. And I believe this is also covered in that video link in the description. It's good stuff, I tell you. I tells you, it's good stuff. So as you see, I actually get pretty fast at this. And it gives you something to do on the way back. Otherwise, you're just running along, looking at stuff you can't mine. I also do them this close to the torch because the light actually goes into these all the way to the end, so no baby things can even spawn in them. Oh, see that? See, that's taking a lot longer than, say, that. We have a friend in there. So get your sword ready. Okay. Think I got them all. Oh, that's a lot of them. Yep, silverfish, silverfish. All right. And as a finishing touch, I am going to be going back in there because I left some stuff in there. But usually what I would do is I would dig this out a little bit and put a block right there. That way, even if there was stuff in there coming this way, it's too high for them to jump over. Spiders are too fat, and everything else needs to jump higher. So I might just do that anyways. I'll do that. So that's my little safety precaution in case I turn my back on it and I'm in here. So you may find yourself asking, how did the pros get obsidian? Well, I'll tell you. You put down your water, and when you mine the obsidian, the water actually makes it solidify underneath if there's any lava, so that the obsidian won't fall through and burn up. Haha, see? So I was able to pick that up, the obsidian block, before the lava burned it because the water made it harden too fast. Oh, there's the flowers from before. That's menacing. Like vultures watching. Alright, I might put down another chest out here just for minerals. Something else that invariably starts happening is I end up having to have a cobblestone chest. Alright, so we gotta wrangle these cows. You gotta give them a home. They're just all over the place. So this worked fine. Maybe I can breed them one more time. one more time. And then, figure out where to put them. So I'm gonna make a bunch of fences. That would be a lot of gates, so I'm not going to do that. That would be disastrous. Okay, fences. And I'm going to designate one of these houses to be in charge of cows. Whichever one has a nice area around it. This is actually a nice area. I'm going to draft this area, probably, into taking care of the cows. I need to get an axe, though. I need to make some room. If I didn't know better, I'd say that I broke that grass and got an apple out of it. It's very odd. Alright, so I cleared a bunch of trees. Now I'm going to kind of make the ground a bit less intrusive. Alright, that looks like a pretty natural curve of the land. Gonna have to replace this though. Ooh, I want it! Apple! Oh, okay, thanks. Yep, still clearing it out. Takes a little bit of work to do something like this. Oh, look at this. A nice, happy area for a bunch of nice, happy cows. So, I'm gonna put down a little fence. Little fence time. I'm gonna accidentally get some other animals in here, I have a feeling. Not sure if it can be helped. Ha! Denied. Might as well get some of these guys in here. Hey, hey, buddy. Go over here. Okay. Yeah, come over here. Okay, stick around. Yeah, get out of here, sheep. Sheep, get, shoot. Alright, so hopefully, if I didn't screw this up... Oh, I did screw it up. Whatever. There's going to be a way for me to get out, which is... I jump onto this, sprint off, I'm out. They can't do that, so they can't get out. I'm going to have a way in, which is this. So let's lure some of these in here. Oh, beautiful. Beautiful. You know what? As a reward, you all get money. No. You all get to have some lovin'. Get over here. Got some lovin' to do. I'm matchmaker. Get over here. Oh, see, this is the beauty of this system. They can only come in. Or I guess they did their things. Okay. Oh, this rabbit. Get out of here. Get out of here. Oh, they... Can they get over that? I can't tell. Alright, whatever. Continue. Yeah, this little garden has been putting in work. Like, I thought it was gonna be upgraded, like, really soon. I thought I was wasting my time making a small garden, but... Like, this thing's a champ. Just through and through. Like, other gardens should look up to this garden. It's a little garden that could. Well, I seem to have gotten a sheep. I figured this would happen eventually. I really want to keep the sheep down to a minimum. Because I want to keep them separate. Oh, this is going to be a good one. We got a lot of them. Good haul. Oh, sheep's toward the back. Maybe I can time this just right that the sheep loses interest. Oh, I did it! I'm so pro! Beautiful. You're still... Okay, whatever. What a lovely cow farm. I'm debating whether to kill the rest of them, because there's a lot of them in there, or bring them back. Oh, there is a cow over there. Alright, Come on, cow. Be smart. Yes. Yes. No! Okay, you're fine. This rabbit. It's just, I hope it stays there forever now. Alright, looks good. Beautiful things are happening in here. This could go on forever. Oh, there's a tree cow. Okay. I might just kill the rest. This is a lot. There's a lot of cows in there. The fall killed it, not me. Oh, I get a... I should check those. So... Cow tipper... Oh, really? You need to do them in that order? Okay. You know what? I can't do this one. There's no other players. Maybe I can throw into myself? I don't... I'll have to look into that. But I can get this one. So we need a book. Let's go ahead and do that. Let's do a book. We have the two diamonds. We need the obsidian, which I got. Need four of them. We'll make the pedestal. Ew. Cool. I think we're going to be real sloppy. Wait, no, we have a house. We can designate a house to this. I kind of like this one, but it's really far away. Huh. It's not really practical. It's gonna be stupid if it's out in the middle. How's this? I don't know. All right. We're gonna be. What do I want to do? I'm gonna take my frustration out on some of these cows. What I'm gonna do is I'm going to make them have a baby. Repopulate. Kill its parents right in front of it. Sorry, buddy, but you're gonna need to go somewhere else. Maybe it'll find. Actually, where is it gonna go? It's gonna try to find an adult, right? Well, if all the adults are in that one area, maybe it'll find the other area. Unless there's any renegades out here. There is a renegade. I'm gonna make so many books. Oh, I hear you. There you are. Okay. Alright, I'm gonna do some, let's call it cleansing. It's so terrible. And get rid of all these, cows. Wait, maybe I get them to, No, they're probably not thinking about that right now. Oh, they are. Look how quickly they forgive and forget. It's like nothing happened. Alright, I think that's enough killing of cows for now. Oh, I have food. That's right, game. I have food. Oh, hello. Okay, let's put that one there. Alright, I'm really close to just throwing this, like, on the ground right here. I don't know what else to do with it for now. Let's go in here. Boom. Enchantments are now possible. That's kind of cool. No. Oh, perfect. Alright. This might actually be enough for this episode. So, in recap, for some good mining, we have a spot for the cows now, so they're not running all over the creation. And we got a crafting table. So, let's see what we can do. There's still quite a few things left to do. Obviously, we can always use more stuff, but I do want to map out this area with, like, actual maps. Like, looking at it before was one thing, but getting actual maps. So, that'll be a fun little project. And also, cleaning up these trees, getting some paths in for the, to lead to the houses. And kind of, probably get a bigger farm than this one going. I don't know about automations yet. We'll see. But anyways, this is RedMcNed signing off.